A meeting has been held today in Rira City between the Lango sub-region leaders and leaders of the Ministry of Works and Transport, as well as the Uganda National Road Authority, to iron out issues of the road network in the region. During the meeting, the chairperson of the Lango Parliamentary Caucus, Judith Ariek, handed a petition to the General Katumba Wamala, who is the Minister of Transport and Works, about the status of roads in the sub-region.
In light of these challenges, Lango Parliamentary Group petitions the Ministry of Works and Transport for affirmative action on Lango roads, commencing with the NDP3. As part of this affirmative action, we propose the following. 1. Planned road construction or reconstruction in NDP3, 520 kilometers. We have the following.
Petition, I've received it. We are going to look at it. We are going to respond back through the chair of the LG Lango Parliamentary Group.
One of the issues in the petition include transferring over 300 kilometers of roads from the district network to the national road network.
We have about 354.9 kilometers of this road. So we present the following roads totaling to that length for upgrade from district roads to national roads. The respective district councils have already approved and forwarded the request to the Ministry of Works. These roads are the following. We have Agweng Barjobi.
The district chairman and the district engineers, you know the process of how a road moves from being a district road to be taken on as a national road. Please follow that process. Don't waste time writing to UNRA to take over a road. They will not. Because the law provides that it's me, the minister, who can authorize UNRA to take on a national road.
The area leaders are also demanding from government to rehabilitate roads that have been affected by the floods, as well as putting in place bridges that have been swept away by water.
There are some structures which the districts cannot address, especially bridges and crossing points. Those will have the first call, because districts cannot address that. The money they get, the technical know-how they get, cannot address those issues. So those ones shall have first call to us.
The local leaders are calling on government to ensure that local content is emphasized during the awarding of contracts by ensuring that 80% of the employees are from the region.
I would request for the list of all employees from all the contractors to be presented to Lango Parliamentary Group for assessment. Less than that, we have the right to cancel the contracts.
I would propose that maybe the local contractor, the small local contractors who are here, they be the ones to organize the manpower and contract them. So these foreign contractors contract Katumba to bring the 50 workers, and Katumba is responsible for those 50 workers. If they disappear, Katumba pays.
The leaders here in Lango sub-region are also asking that they should be given space to inspect some of the projects that are happening in their area. Juma Kiria, NTV, Lira.